Okay, everybody, it's been a long time. It's been a couple of weeks. We're back here with the PT6 model kit, and I'm just gonna do some free comments, free association, freestyle, not really, just some comments that spill out of my tiny little brain. Okay, so the instructions are, first of all, the description of the PT6 engine, I wanna wipe that out, okay? We want somebody, either me or you, somebody, is going to write a one-page summary essentially describing what a turboprop engine is and what the PT6 is, how it may be the same or different from other turboprops. Bing bang. Very generic, nothing super special. This one is unacceptable. And then the instructions. It says things like, well, let's go back there. Let's just be fair here. Use of matching tools during installation and check whether the parts are complete before installation. We don't know whether the parts are complete because there's no list. Okay, there is no list of parts. The parts aren't numbered and they don't have names. Okay, the description of the parts is simply not there. There is a diagram here, and the problem is the labels and the lines going to the parts is a different, I guess, a cell or a sheet. It's not done digitally, they're overlaid and they're out of sync. So you've got it says power turbine, it points to a shaft. Let's look at this. All right, you can see that, can't you? We're looking here at the, says air intake. That's not the air intake. The air intake's here. It says accessory gearbox. That's actually down below there. And, so centrifugal compressor, nope, that's down here. Power turbine, nope, that's actually up here. So the lines pointing to things. So if I already know what the parts are, or generally what they're called, if I know what a turbine is and a compressor and a bearing, the lines are going to the wrong place. So they're not helping explain to anybody who doesn't know exactly about the engine what they are. And even if they did go right to the thing, you're pointing to a part of a completed cross-section. And it says, for example, combustor, combustion chamber. It doesn't say that here. This has no name on it and no number, and no other part has a number on it. So you gotta really know your stuff to pick out the right thing, which is, that's inadequate for a model kit. Another thing that I find unusual is you've got a thing called a cartridge receiver one. A cartridge receiver 2, and a receiver 2. What's that? Must be some kind of a glitch. Cartridge receiver 3 and cartridge receiver 4. Okay? I don't use that term, and I build turbine engines. There's no explanation of what is meant by a cartridge receiver. You can guess. You can say, well, that thing slips into there, but there's no terminology of cartridge receiver with turbine engines. It sounds like we're building a gun. I don't know, is there a thing called a cartridge receiver in a gun? I know there's cartridges, and I know there's receivers. Is there a cartridge receiver? I don't know. Anyway, I'm ranting here, but this is an honest review of a model kit, and I'm trying to do this one thing. I'm trying to put the, let's see what they call it. Just for fun, we're on stage two, step two now. Step two? Oh, step three. Assembly of exhaust device and cartridge receiver 2. An exhaust device. We never use those terms either because device means anything. In the Manhattan Project, the device meant the atom bomb. A device could be anything. Here's a device. There's a device. Exhaust device. That's a minor infraction. A cartridge receiver 2. What's that? Anyway, this is the inner, what do you call it? The inner portion of the exhaust duct. And this is the outer portion of the exhaust duct. And they sort of fit together like this. Not really. It's a bit stiff. It's a bit big. This is a bit big to fit in there. And so what happens is, let's see. Okay, I want to get this right, show you what I'm dealing with. This goes in there, okay? And it's, you can see it's a little bit big, so it kind of
You can hold it in place. It puts the green thing into a bit of a spring effect. It'll just pop right back out. And you're supposed to screw it together with these three screws. They go into these three holes. I don't know if you can see three holes there, but the holes are sort of threaded. They kind of go in, but not really. You're gonna have to chew your way in with your number zero Phillips screwdriver. Number zero, this is I guess they're fairly common, but it's not included with the kit. I was talking about special tooling and there is no tooling here. Anyway, to get this to do this, and I want to do up that, I've got the screw loaded into the hole, okay? I got two of them, two out of three. Got this here. And let's just go through this live here for fun. Let's hold it in place. Hold it in place. Now I've got to make sure that the screw lines up. So I've got my alignment punch, pick, whatever, something that's also not included in the model. And I want to get that so the screw hole lines up with the other screw hole. Sort of. I'm putting pressure on this now. Let's see if I can do up one of these screws. Maybe. Doing it up. Wouldn't that be funny if it worked this time? I've done this two or three times so far, attempted to do it. Oh, looks like it's gonna go. It's going, maybe. Okay, is it started? It is started. Okay, well, it's a real pain in the butt to get this to work, but apparently it's worked this time. And it's extremely finicky. There's no real feeling for the end of the torque point for the screw. And let's see if that stays there, if I can get another one in. Maybe. I could be whining about nothing, people. Let's see, this one. Oh, all right. Is it gonna go? Is it gonna stay in there? This one flipped out. Or did it? Something's happening. Nothing is all, no, it's not lined up there. It didn't go in. It's just pushing. I don't know if you can see there. There's a screw in there. Hang on. So let's see where we are. Got a bit of light. Okay. I don't know if you can see the screw or where am I? Where are you? The screw it's pushing against the green thing. It hasn't gone into the screw hole. Because. All right, there's a screw and a hole and a hole, and they all have to be lined up. And there is no, if I push the green thing up against this spigot all the way, then the holes are not lined up. So there is no way to hold it in place and screw it together. It's kind of like a two-person or a three-person operation. And for a model kit, the frustration factor is extremely high. You can probably hear that in my voice. And it gets you asking to yourself, is this worth it? Is it worth doing this? Because what's the final result? The final result is an inaccurate representation of a real world thing. And this is supposed to be, it even says in there, it says, take care of it because it can be used for display purposes. Well, as we've already discussed, I don't want to get into a rant here, but this is all turning on a single shaft. And that's not how a PT6 works. PT6 has a compressor that's turned by a turbine. That is one section, okay? That's one section. One shaft, and it turns at 45,000 RPM. The power turbine is a separate shaft, and it turns at 30,000 RPM. It's two shafts turning, so you can't replicate that with one. And yes, it's a simplification of a model, but if it's a model for training purposes or demonstration purposes, it's not doing the job. This is not what a PT6 looks like when it's running. It ain't. So, hang on. All right, so in order to put the extreme effort and finickiness into this thing, it's a really frustrating to line up these parts. In the real world, there would be special jigs and tools to make this possible, but for the lack of accuracy of the way this thing finishes up, is it worth it putting this extreme effort into it to make something that isn't really a good representation or model of the thing you're trying to model? Answer is no. So two choices, SkyMech man. It needs to be so that it literally snaps into place. Now you may want to screw things together when it snaps into place, but it's got to snap into place and be easy to stabilize while you're putting the screws in. This is if you watch my videos about building the Arenda 14, I do a lot of very, very difficult procedures and extremely difficult to get at fasteners and lining things up and whatever. But what we have in the end is a jet engine for an aircraft. This could be made so much easier. If this thing snapped in there and stayed, and then in that position of snapping together where I'm holding it right now, if the screws would go in, that'd be great, but the screws don't go in there. The screws go in when it's back a couple of millimeters and it's still sprung against a conical surface. So it's a pain in the rear to hold it with your two hands. Then you need your third and fourth hand to hold the tiny screw, line up the screwdriver, and start driving it in. And the holes in the plastic, they look like they're threaded, but they're not. They're 3D printed. And these ones, are they? They're attempting to thread them, but the parts tolerance are not close enough. They don't go into the right position so you can fasten them. You've got to hold two weird shaped parts under tension in a weird position, an unnatural position for their shapes, and then, see, I've got two hands here. My other hand, my third hand, needs to hold the screw, and my fourth hand needs to run the screwdriver. So as a model kit for anybody but advanced model builders, it's unacceptable. And an advanced model builder does not want to build something that doesn't act like the real thing or doesn't even look like the real thing. Just saying. So we have description is unacceptable. There is no master parts list. There's no diagram describing what the parts are. The parts are not numbered. Like if the parts were on a, like they come with a model kit, they have little numbers beside them, 1 through 100 or whatever, and you break off number one, there's a diagram, and the instruction says that is the front landing gear of your starfighter, or whatever. Or that's the machine gun from the left side on the wings of your Spitfire. There's no labels of any kind on these things. You just look at it, and the instructions call them by a name different from what they really are. The cartridge receiver. Well, that could be a bearing housing, because a bearing, sometimes it's called a cartridge, but usually the bearing contains the rollers and the races, the inner and outer races. That goes into a cartridge, and that cartridge goes into a housing. So what part of the engine is the cartridge receiver? Well, you could say it's the diameter in the case, the casing. This would be the forward accessory casing. There's a diameter in there that would take a bearing. You push the bearing in. So this could be called a cartridge receiver, but that's not what it's called. So if you're building a model to be representing or similar to or learning a little bit about the thing, why use a different language? And I'm not talking about English versus some other language. I mean the language of the mechanicals and the technical stuff. There's a bearing. This is a bicyclist call this a cartridge bearing. So you could say, okay, cartridge receiver. Cartridge receiver would be the diameter in the plastic within which the bearing gets pushed in. But even this one, It has to be forced in. Like, I would be worried pressing this in. Is it going to crack the plastic? And that's not what you do when you want to have a model kit for amateurs to enjoy building. This is, I may not finish this model, okay? I'm looking for somebody to rewrite the description which is at the beginning. I know this video is turning into a rant, and I apologize for that, but I promised them I'd give an honest review. So, product introduction. Turbine engine is a kind of fuel engine. Throw that out. That's meaningless crap. Which is widely used in driving aircraft, especially civil aircraft. That's accurate. The PT6 is a very popular turboprop engine for civilian and light aircraft, medium to light aircraft. It's a very good engine. This design requires an engine that can operate efficiently at airspeed between a propeller aircraft, low speed, and a pure turbojet high speed. That's all efficiently at airspeed between a propeller aircraft. It is a propeller aircraft. Like, I'm nitpicking here because this has to be educational, and it's not. The working turbofan engine was first developed by German and British engineers in the 40s as part of extensive development of turbine engineering. That's all meaningless crap. The working turbofan engine was developed in the 50s. It was theoretically drawn out by Frank Whittle, it was. But we're not even, this isn't a turbofan engine, it's a turboshaft engine, just to bring out a detail. No, I can't do that, I don't have touch screen. The term turbofan engine, again, why are we talking about those? Describes the combination of a gas turbine engine fan, usually a propeller installed in a circular duct. That's not what a turbofan is. It's not a propeller in a duct. An engine that provides thrust, a central turbine fan that generates airflow, and an air. This is all so confusing, I would just erase it. Okay, so we've erased all of it, except for the fact that the PT6 is a very popular civilian aircraft engine. Early turbofan engines, we don't care because this is not a turbofan. Blah, 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 the bypass ratio. There is no bypass ratio in a PT6. Airflow, blah, 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 turbofan. Since the addition of fans has relatively little impact on the fuel trumpet in the central core of the engine, that means nothing. The addition of fans. All right, but can provide greater thrust increase. What he's trying to say is a turbofan engine, the fan creates a great deal more thrust and doesn't, it does affect the fuel burning core by supercharging it. It's actually beneficial, which is good. That's a good thing. But it's not a turboshaft engine. Very high fuel efficiency, that's also true, together with its lower noise than the low bypass engine. He was just talking about turbofans versus turbojets. A turbojet is not a low bypass engine. A low bypass engine and a high bypass engine are both turbofans, and neither one of those has anything to do with the PT6. I know I sound angry, but I'm having fun here. You guys can read this if you want. When you're going to rewrite this, you don't have to follow it and correct it. You can wipe out the whole thing and start over, which is what I recommend. Yeah. Okay, I can't go on. It's just this is longer, but this is roughly a one page summary of what the thing is, and it's got nothing to do with what this is. This is a generic, a very fractured and largely incorrect summary of turbofan engines and their development. So not only is it not very good, it's about completely the wrong subject, so it's completely irrelevant to this model kit. Just saying. I believe that if somebody's interested in writing a proper one-page summary of turboshafts as a type of turbine engine and the benefits of the PT6 specifically, maybe not even that specific, just a one-page summary, that would enormously benefit SkyMec man and DIY engine. Because that's what they need. This is no good. If I was marking this out of 10, it would get a 2. That's a fail. It needs to be replaced, and I'm counting on you guys to do that. Whoever makes the best one, the best one-page summary of the PT6, I will give you this model. I might even put it together for you and send it to you, or I'll just send you the box, okay? And then we're going to send your summary to DIY Engines and say, here's your new instructions, or your new introduction, and we will suggest that they rewrite the instructions on how to put this thing together. Because it's inadequate. That diagram is bad. The instructions, they aren't instructions. Install the spindle. The first thing they need is a page that shows all the pictures, all of them. This thing, this thing, this thing, everything, with an arrow pointing to it and saying what it is. Now, I know they think they've done that here, the overall view, but they haven't. The names are different, and it's inaccurate. So, where are we? We're at here. And it says, assembly of the exhaust device and cartridge receiver 2. Align the holes and assemble them in the order shown in figure 3-2. That's right here. Align the holes. After assembly, the effect is shown. Okay, so really, would be easy. We're going to shorten this up now. I'm not going to go on too much longer. But if this just slammed in there like that and the holes lined up and, oh, you put them in, bing, bang. It's not. I messed with this for, 10 minutes, and then I gave up. That's the point where I was thinking, why do I want to do this? If it was a model, it was an Airfix model of a Spitfire, you don't have to do a precision alignment and maintain things in position with supports like on a lathe to put the propeller on the front. It just goes on. And if this was to be like an engineering practice model, well, then the parts should be accurate, and those screws wouldn't even be here. So I don't quite get. I understand the enthusiasm, but the way of going about this is no good. And there's no mention of the motor. Remember, there's no mention of the motor. Cartridge receiver 3. Assemble, line the holes, assemble. There's a lot of putting screws in. As a model builder, well, what can I say? As a model builder, I really don't like this. As an engine technician, I really don't like this. As somebody who's interested in turboprop engines, I really don't like this. It's got great potential, but it's just the edges are ragged and frayed, you know? What kind of person is this for? That's what you, like, I could put a lot of effort into, and I could put some skill and effort into getting this thing working. But then it doesn't behave like a PT6. So why would I want to? If you want a model kit where you push a button and something turns, there's kits out there, and they just snap together. They're simple, they're inaccurate, they turn the wrong way. But, things turn, it looks cool. So if you have this thing all made together, and maybe the next video I'll put it together, but when it's, or maybe I'll make another video after it's put together, or maybe I won't put it together. Once it's all put together and it's turning, it's a thing that turns and it looks cool and it's got nothing to do with the real thing. You know? I don't know. I'm going to end that here because I'm just ranting. I was frustrated and I've worked it out a little bit. I feel better, but it's, I'm sorry, SkyMec man and Engine DIY, but you should probably not show my video. Yeah. Okay, SkyMec man, engine DIY and model builders out there, this is a potentially great kit, okay? It needs to be, have a better description. It doesn't even need the description. They could leave the description right out. It needs better illustrations. It needs marked parts. Somehow they need to be identified as whatever they are. They need more consistent reference to the parts in the illustrations. And with a couple of slight changes in the design, if I could just hold these together and screw them together, bing bang, be no big deal, right? But it's takes four hands, four of my two hands need to be used to do that, or some kind of a special jig with an arbor press, none of which is supplied. Even if they had an illustration of what tools to use and how to do it, that'd be great. So it's got great potential, but it needs a bit of work. I'm not saying any of the other kits by Sky Mech Man or anything like this, because I haven't seen them. I've seen the completed versions. But these are fairly expensive. It's fairly expensive. So it should be hassle-free. You know, that's all I'm saying. Great potential, needs a little bit of work. I wish you success. Thanks for watching.